Hello, today, Death of Marco Pantani by Matt Randall. This is a biography book that I read just one time. It was 1 year ago or something like this. And I have to say, this is a very sad book. It's not a very positive story of some successful athlete. It's biography of the man who had very hard to understand mindset, who was very close, who was very hard to cooperate with, and who died very early because overusing cocaine, which was the result of the hype around Pantani after excluding from Giro Italia in 1999, where he was found of exceeding the limit of allowed hematocrit, which was 50, and this was the reason he was accused of overusing EPO. He left the race, and from that time, I think the big fall of Pantani started. This book is well written. I think Matt Randall is a very good journalist. He is the author also of King of the Mountains, very good book. Inside the book, you might find some nice pictures of early days from even from childhood regarding Marco Pantani. You can find some pictures from races like Tour de France. So I always appreciate such materials in the book apart from the pure text. So Marco Pantani, a word about this athlete. So it's arguably one of the best climbers in the history of cycling. Probably you can easily put his side by side with Contador or Andy Schleck or whoever was an icon. Pantani was also the icon. There is a lot of confusion around this athlete because some people claim that he was a product of using performance-enhancing drugs, but some people claim that he had got a talent, although he has using EPO as many riders, or maybe almost all the riders from the pro peloton from that time. Of course, as many riders from that era, from the 90s, he was never caught on using EPO or testosterone. He was never tested positive because there were no proper methods, or the methodology was not performed in the best way to figure out whether some rider is using drugs. So he was never tested positive. The only reason he was excluded from the Giro Italia in 1999 was that his hematocrit was over 50. So, because it was the only indicator that something is wrong with your blood, so something supernatural is happening inside your body. Till that time, there were no hematocrit limit. So there is also evidence that in early 90s his hematocrit examined in hospital after his accident during Giro Italia, sorry, during Tour de France, as I remember, the hematocrit was above 60, so it's insane number. So in 1999 there was a hematocrit limit which excluded him from the race, and I think that was the turning point in his career. According to this book, also, when he ran into troubles, he started overusing cocaine. He felt very, very lonely. But it's not the fault. There is no one to blame about this from his environment, because he had very hard to cooperate mindset. He was, as I said in the beginning, very closed. Human, like introvertic, I would say. So, if you have such athlete in your team, you need a very good sports psychologists or, you know, people that can support such athlete. So this is the example of extremely talented athlete from my perspective that overused performance enhancing drugs because all the riders also were using this. So the difference between Pantani and Lenz, for example, is that he was just cooperating with different doctor, Fuentes, but Lenz was cooperating with infamous Michael Ferrari. So this book is, as I said, is kind of a sad book. It's, you know, by reading this, you might find yourself like a bit overwhelmed by some facts, by some sad stories. I think he was not happy in his life. There were some moments, but my feeling is that although he was successful in sport, he was not happy at all. Maybe this is because his character, his mindset. But he left big legacy. I think there are many people around the world and also in Italy who are inspired by this athlete. I think the Miguel Indurain said something like this, that Pantani, maybe there will be something better than him, but there will be no one who can attract other people to cycling like Pantani did. It's enough to say that at the peak of his career, when he won in 1 year Tour de France and Giro Italia, he was more famous in Italy than football players, for example. Yeah, so it's hard to imagine that in a country where the football is a kind of religion, this cyclist, the rider, might be more popular. But that was the fact. Yeah, so according to many experts, Marco Pantani was the only rider who was able to compete with Lance Armstrong. You remember maybe from, I believe, from Tour de France in 2000, there was an epic climb on Mont Ventoux when both were riding to the finish line. And Lance Armstrong let Pantani win. And I think Pantani recognized that. So he was very furious on the next stage. You might find also some mentions about this in the book Secret Race from the Jonathan Voters. Okay, so I recommend this book, although it's very sad. It's there are some chapters that might be hard to understand because there are some medical words used. But as a complete book, I appreciate it much. So I think it's the mandatory position for everyone who is interested in cycling history, especially in early 90s and late 90s, because this era of superhumans on bicycles was the most interesting. All right, so it's enough about this book. Now a few words about some things that are still to come. So you might expect two short reviews of those two books, One Way Ticket by Jonathan Waters and Lance Armstrong, It's Not About the Bike. So still stay in touch and bye.